हेलो गाइस, स्वागत है आपका मेरा यूट्यूब चैनल खत्री बावा स्टेनो वाले। सो गाइस, अभी तक हमने किया जीडी बिस्ट की एक लीगल डिक्टेशन। सो आज हम उसी जीडी बिस्ट की एक्सरसाइज नंबर सेकंड करेंगे। सो बी रेडी फॉर इट, गेट रेडी, स्टार्ट। हाउएवर द कंसिडरेशन पार्टेनिंग टू द वेलफेयर ऑफ द चाइल्ड मे इंडिकेट लॉफुल कस्टडी विद अनदर फ्रेंड और रिलेटिव एज सर्विंग हिज हर इंटरेस्ट बेटर। द क्वेश्चन ऑफ गार्डियनशिप कैन बी इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ एंड डिस्टिंक्ट फ्रॉम दैट ऑफ कस्टडी इन फैक्ट्स एंड सर्कमस्टांसिस ऑफ ईच केस। द कोर्ट शाल डिटरमाइन वेदर इन प्रोसीडिंग्स रिलेटिंग टू इंटरिम कस्टडी देर आर सफिशेंट एंड कंपेलिंग रीजन्स टू परसुएड द कोर्ट टू चेंज द कस्टडी ऑफ द माइनर चिल्ड्रन विद इमिडिएट इफेक्ट। स्टेबिलिटी एंड कंसिस्टेंसी इन द अफेयर्स एंड रूटीन्स ऑफ चिल्ड्रन इज ऑल्सो एन इम्पोर्टेंट कंसिडरेशन। Keeping in mind the paramount consideration of welfare of the children, the custody of the children which currently rests with their maternal relatives is not disturbed as the scope of this order is limited. The appellant in response to these submissions contended that the High Court could not interfere with the findings of the family court unless serious infirmity is proven. The decision cited by the respondents were distinguished on the ground that these decisions concerns findings that were recorded after a full-fledged trial and not an order passed as an ad interim relief granting custody to one of the parties. The High Court in its impugned judgment had held that while appointing the guardian or deciding the matter of custody of the minor children during the pendency of guardianship proceedings, the first and foremost consideration for the court is the welfare of the children. The factors that must be kept in mind while determining the question of guardianship will apply with equal force to the question of interim custody. It was observed that the family court should have delved a little deeper into the matter and ascertained where the interest of the children lay instead of recording abstract findings. Questions of prima facie case, balance of convenience and irreparable injury. The terms on which the appellant and his deceased wife were the manner in which the respondents obtained the custody of the children are questions that should be determined during the course of trial. Though when the children's father is not unfit otherwise, he shall be the natural guardian. A child cannot be forced to stay with his her father. According to the High Court, merely because the father has love and affection for his children and is not unfit to take care of the children, the welfare of children cannot be granted. So guys, ये थी हमारी डिक्टेशन, जी डी बिस्ट की लीगल डिक्टेशन, 80 वर्ड्स पर मिनट। सो यहाँ हमारी डिक्टेशन ख़त्म होती है। सो इसकी भी बहुत अच्छे से प्रैक्टिस करना, हो सके तो इसको 6 से 7 बार लिखना। सो गाइस, ओके बाय।